ها؟ نعم.
The cave with Abu Bakr before the Hijrah.
عندما كان يسكن في الغار مع أبي بكر رضي الله عنه قبل الهجرة.
نعم، الله سبحانه وتعالى اختار من الخلق الصحابة رضي الله عليهم أن يكونوا هم أفضل الخلق بعد الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for the companions, the Sahaba, to be the best of the people, the best of mankind after the prophets and the messengers.
واختار من الصحابة رضي الله عليهم أبو بكر رضي الله عنه.
And from amongst the Sahaba, the companions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه to be best amongst them.
وكان أبو بكر رضي الله عنه هو ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار، يعني هو كان الذي هاجر مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعم.
And Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه he was as Allah subhanahu described him the second of the two in the cave, meaning he was the only one who made hijrah and accompanied the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when making hijrah.
نعم. نعم. يقول قال الله سبحانه وتعالى لقد جاءكم أي والله لقد جاءكم. نعم.
Allah subhanahu mentioned in the Quran لقد جاءكم verily there has come to you meaning by Allah verily for sure there has come to you.
رسول من أنفسكم يعني من البشر مثل مثلكم.
A messenger from amongst yourselves meaning a messenger who is a human who is like you a human being.
تميز عنا بالرسالة ينزل عليه الوحي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
But that which he was distinguished above us that he was given the رسالة the message or the revelation from the heavens.
عزيز عليه ما عنتم يعني يشق عليه كل ما يشق عليه. وهذا من رحمة الله سبحانه وتعالى بنا أن كان هذا النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام موصوف بهذا الخلق العظيم. بادل غاية الجهد في دفع كل ما يضر بنا ومنه الشرك. نعم. وبادل غاية الجهد في جلب المحبوب المستفاد من قوله حريص عليكم وما ترك شيء يقربنا إلى الله إلا أمرنا به ولا شيء يبعدنا عن الله إلا ونهانا عنه. نعم.
And then Allah subhanahu described him عزيز عليه ما عنتم that difficult upon him that which you must bear. Meaning, that which harms or hurts you, it harms and hurts the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And for this reason, he was diligent and took every care in guiding us away from everything which hurts or harms us. And the greatest and most severe of this is ash-shirk. And also that he tried his utmost to guide us towards where there is our benefit and there is our goodness. And this is from the saying of Allah, Harisun Alaikum, meaning also focused on your betterment and your salvation. If we consider the responsibilities which the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was tasked with,
ماذا كان يصنع عليه الصلاة والسلام؟ هو نبي ورسول عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
And what were those responsibilities that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was given? Firstly, he was a prophet and a messenger, a Nabi and a Rasul.
يتلقى الوحي من جبريل.
And that he would receive revelation from Jibreel.
يحفظ القرآن.
He would memorize the Quran.
هو رئيس الدولة.
And he was also the leader of the state.
هو وزير الداخلية، وزير الدفاع.
And he is the
تقريباً يعني.
And he was the interior minister and the minister of defense.
نعم. هو إمام المسجد.
And he was the imam of the masjid.
هو المعلم.
And he was the teacher.
هو المفتي.
And he was also the one who gave
يقوم بشؤون أهله.
And at the same time, he used to take care after his family.
وظائف كثيرة جدا.
Meaning the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he played various roles and fulfilled various responsibilities.
قام بكل وظيفة أكمل قيام.
And despite all of these responsibilities and roles, he fulfilled every single one in the best and most perfect manner.
لعلك أنت وظيفة واحدة ما تستطيع عليها أن تأتي كما أتى بها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. والله سبحانه.
And perhaps you only you if you were to be given only one role or one responsibility that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has given you, you would not be able to fulfill.
بارك الله سبحانه وتعالى له في عمله في وقته. نعم.
But Allah placed barakah for our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in his time and his actions and his efforts.
نعم. اختاره الله سبحانه وتعالى بأن يكون أفضل نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And Allah Subhanahu, He chose the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be the best and most virtuous amongst the prophets.
اختار له هذا الدين دين كامل ودين يختم به. نعم.
And Allah Subhanahu chose for him this religion, this perfect religion, and the religion through him which is perfect. يعني it's the final religion.
اختار له أفضل صحابة, أفضل زوجات.
And also Allah Subhanahu decreed for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the best and most virtuous of companions and wives.
أفضل بلد.
And also, and also to be born in the best of cities, i.e. the city of Makkah.
أشرف الناس, أعلى الناس خلقا عليه الصلاة والسلام. أشرف الناس نسبا. نعم, أفضل نسب كان للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعم.
And he was the most noble of people in lineage, meaning the most noble lineage of, amongst the people was the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was the best of them in his character and his manners.
شرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وشرف للأمة.
And so this is a great honor for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it is also a great honor for his ummah.
تكريم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تكريم لأمته.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being honored and elevated is also the ummah being honored and elevated.
فهل بعد هذا لا تتبع هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تستن بسنته لا تتمسك بها. نعم.
So then after all of this, how can it be that you don't follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you don't follow his guidance, you don't live your life according to the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
لابد أن تفرح أن الله سبحانه وتعالى اختارك بأن تكون من أتباع هذا النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Rather, you should be pleased and delighted that Allah chose you to be the followers of this noble Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
نعم. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام هو أنصح الخلق للخلق عليه الصلاة والسلام. لا يوجد من ينصح للخلق أفضل من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعم.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was the most sincere in advice from amongst the creation towards creation. Meaning, there's no other created being who was more sincere than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم towards creation.
أعبد الناس لا طريق إلى عبادة الله إلا عن طريق عليه الصلاة والسلام. لا يمكن أن نأتي بعبادة مساوية لعبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فضاعت العبادة أكثر منها. لا بد أن تكون عبادتنا دائما دون عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعم.
And he صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was the most worshipping of the people towards Allah subhanahu, meaning there's nobody who can come after him who is equal to the worship of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Never mind being more worshipping of Allah than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Anybody who comes after him, without doubt, they are less worshipping and less pious than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
لا يمكن لأحد أن يعرض عن سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And neither is it possible or permitted for a person to oppose or turn away from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
لا نزيد ولا ننقص من سنته عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And it's not permitted for a Muslim to increase above the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and neither to be deficient in anything from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
والله أعلم، صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم، وجزاكم الله خيرا.
Okay, inshallah, because we have been on a long journey for the past few days, and then there's a lesson after Asr as well. We're going to stop there today with this lesson. The Sheikh has further lessons in Masjid Tawheed in Hyde, which is after Asr, and then and also in Masjid Salam. Which area? Mosside. And also Masjid Salam in Mosside after Maghrib. So the Sheikh will be teaching Usul al-Thalatha in Masjid Tawheed in Hyde, and tafsir of the shortest surah of the Quran in Masjid Salam.
Now, أحسن الله إليك مو عليك. نعم ما كان.
قل إليك نعم. Towards you.
أيوه.
مسألة الاستهزاء بالدين.
Some people they say it wasn't my intention. I didn't have any bad will. It was just a joke.
منهم من يقول لما هذا الأمر كان نخوض ونلعب ليس ما كنا ننوي انتقاص الدين وطعن في الدين. So the question of the brother was,
في القصة التي نزلت قل أبي الله وآياته قال يا رسول الله إنا كنا نتحدث حديث الركب نقطع به عنا الطريق قال إحنا فقط نتكلم تتكلم ما بقي تتكلم وتلعب إلا بالكتاب والسنة. نعم.
The question of the brother was that when it comes to mocking or joking about something from Islam, what if a person says, but it wasn't my intention to actually joke about Islam, I didn't intend anything, I wasn't insulting Islam, just mere light-hearted comments. And the Sheikh answered, well, that was there nothing remaining for them to joke about, accept Allah or His deen? In fact, the story behind this ayah, قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ, in which Allah says, say, is it regarding Allah and His ayat and His mention that you were joking about? The story of this ayah, that when this ayah was revealed regarding those people who said, oh, Messenger of Allah, we were only talking like travelers talk, just trying to fill our time, and we did not intend to joke about the religion.
Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قول ثلاث جدهن جد وهزلهن جد, يعني لو كان يستهزئ هذا هو مثل الجاد. نعم من هالرد نصر عبد السلام. نعم.
And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, he mentioned that three matters, when they are mentioned with seriousness, then they are serious. And when they are mentioned light-hearted, they remain serious. And amongst those three matters is joking about the religion. Why? Because it leads to apostasy.
هذا تجده يلعب مثلا بسب أبي يقول أنا أمزح أسب أبي يمكن لو يصنع هذا الله ما يصنع لكن بالنسبة للدين للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لله سبحانه وتعالى يقول أمر عادي. نعم.
This same person, would he amuse and laugh over his father and then say, but I was only amusing about my father? By Allah, he would not do so. But when it comes to religion of Islam, then it's easy for him to joke around regarding it.
Now, Allahu a'lam.